Sorika, hi everyone. Welcome to my channel. I hope you are well and thanks very much for watching. I'm heading down to see Ardtornish Castle here Fort William and we are passing Morvern. Morvern it called. It's around here. The single road track, big pothole. Here we got here. So you should walk straight down here to the castle down this way. But I went to the wrong way because there's no sign posting to tell me how or where should I go. But it's nice scenery, you know, beautiful. I'm start walking down on the single track road here. Well, it's farm road, but you could do with a crossover bike. It'd be quite easy to get there, I think. I'm halfway through now. That's the way it was before, looking back. And the flock of sheep everywhere. They're quite friendly, you know. And could follow this one down right to the end of where those tree is. Got here now. And Lochaline is still, must be beautiful in the summer. And you should go straight down there, down on the wall there. And I saw the track here and I followed the sheep and walk across. I saw the castle in the distance already. Where it is here, where the arrow pointing there. A sort of rising to do because there's a track there, is how we will get there, but it was wrong. Anyway, I told you the right one already. Here I'm went down here with mud deep to the knee and find my way through here. And it's not an easy way to get there, you know. Need a good valley, a good boots, a hiking boot. And I saw the track here and see clearly how people walk across. I saw that might that be the way how to get there, but anyway, I got there okay and with the very difficult. I got there fine, you know. Thanks very much for watching, by the way. Really appreciate that and great to see you again, my friend, and welcome the newcomer. Welcome to the channel and I really appreciate your guy being here, spend your time in my channel. Thank you very much. We could get there soon, halfway through there. You see what I mean by try to fight through my way, because I didn't know. Anyway, but got there fine, you know. Got here fine. And still way to go. Yes, got here. And this is Ardtornish Castle. To try to find my way up there and go to walk around to have a look around as well. Pan is up to the hill. It's good way for defensive, you know. You can see people come mile away by boat. In the old day, they travel by boat quite a lot. The castle would be rectangular, two-story up with defensive curtain wall. The whole house measures 17.2 by 8.8 meters. The wall around 2.7 meters thick with a thatch of a queue for dry corn and a boathouse as well. Wow, seems to be quite self-efficient to do all that. It's very up in the hill, it's a beautiful view. Must be beautiful view at night as well, looking the moonlight shining to the sea. Quite a romantic thought. I love looking the moon, you know, shining by the sea, must be reflecting the water, must be beautiful. Go to try to go up here, but this must be courtyard. Go up to the hill, we'll find a way to get up here. It's not much left at all, but it's still a good find and a good history. Thank you everyone for watching. So yeah, got here. No wind now. Let's tell you a bit more about this long walk. เดินผ่าป่าผ่าดงมาเหนื่อยค่ะ so tired I feel. It's not a lot to see after that long walk. I can see one window left here. It's amazing, you know, how it still survive on top of the hill with the wind gusting, with the snow, with everything. Fighting everything all year round. The castle was served as a stronghold for the Lord of Islay, the thief and clan Dono. In the 14th century to 15th century, he died at this castle. In 1387, after that, it had been taken over by different generation. The last was his grandson called John MacDonald, the same name as his. He was a resident here in this castle. He sealed the Westminster Ardtornish, signed a treaty in 1461. This pact was agreement with King Edward VI and this possessed by James Douglas, the Earl of Douglas, to cede the control of Scotland at the time and the divide between them. Despite this, the lords of the island still retained the castle until 1493, when King James VI finally broke their power. So what that means, they can strip off their title and all that. After the fall of MacDonald, Ardtornish Castle passed to hand to the MacLean, although precisely how this came about is unclear. Even MacLean themselves, they were recorded as a legal occupant in the record dated 1501, but this successor, Roderick MacLean, was the legal owner in 1541. The castle remained occupied through the MacLean tenure, but this came to an end in 1690 after it passed to the Campbell and was abandoned as a resident. The Campbell had many castles, they had many residents. They quite powerful clan in their own day as well. The castle dipped into ruin until the structure was stabilized in 1873. Later, restoration work conducted in the early 20th century was done by the Scanner Ligard Historical Accuracy. So it had been preserved until what you see today, what it is, it's quite a good condition. Despite all their war, despite all had been through. And please read in the description, there's not a lot of information, but it's good history, you know. I enjoy learning history until today. Every castle I went in is I enjoy very much, love the history. And this castle have been proved very difficult to get through with the winter time. So this will be the last castle for a while. I could wait until the weather get better and I feel really tired, not well lately, but travel a long journey, 3 to 4 hours at a time, and get there having a problem, try to access to the property and all that. Thank you, my friend. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. ขอบคุณมากค่ะที่ติดตาม and happy new year to all of you all the world. And thank you for tuning in. This is the Ardtornish Castle. ขอบคุณมากนะคะที่เข้ามาติดตาม and มืดแล้วค่ะจะรีบกลับ and getting dark now. I feel we can walk back on my own. Scared to go. Thank you again for watching. Bye bye. Lochaline. Keep doing it.
Go back home the dark and rain. It could be the last video of castle for a little while, my friend.
Every day.
กลับบ้านฝนตกหนักค่ะอันนี้วิดีโอเป็นวิดีโอสุดท้ายไม่รู้ว่าจะเข้าไปถ่ายปราสาทได้เมื่อไหร่ค่ะเพราะว่าไปมาลำบากขอบคุณค่ะ
Crossfire.